Hi guys, it's Bella. Welcome to another video in my beauty channel, Marvella Della Nia. And today, I'm going to show you guys how I film and edit my videos. So yeah, it's not really a studio. I'm just trying to answer some frequently asked questions about how I film, like camera, lighting, editing software. I'm going to get in touch to all of that here and give you guys some tips and tricks as well. I'm not saying I'm an expert. I'm not saying that everything I say in this video is correct. These are just some tips and tricks that I'm gonna give to you guys by answering your questions and also trying to help you guys as best as I can. So first of all, let's just talk about the camera. I use a Sony HD camcorder most of the time. I always prefer to use camcorders because they are specifically designed for videography. This camera has high resolution, high definition finish, provides depth of field, and it takes photos while you are recording. Whenever I finish recording a makeup look, I always do the awkward posing moments and the camera is constantly taking photos. I just pick one of those photos, put a text over it, and that's my thumbnail. To edit my photos or thumbnails, I use Adobe Lightroom and Adobe Photoshop CS6. This is my old camera, it is retired. It is a Panasonic Full HD camcorder. I had a problem with temperature sensitivity with this, although it is still a good camera. Temperature sensitivity means that if you have a white something on your screen, it can tend to be yellower or bluer. It's warm or cold. And when you're filming during daylight, the temperature shifts constantly. And when you're filming with this, when the temperature changes, the picture changes. Like one moment I was in orange, the next I was in ice cubes. I just ended up having to edit the hell out of my videos to make sure that it's the same temperature frame to frame. For rare and special occasions, I whip out my baby. This is my Nikon D300S. I used to use a Canon 5D, but I don't prefer this one better. I use it mostly for photography and not really a big fan of using it for videography because this was designed to take photos. You can take a video with this because there's an option here, but this camera was equipped with photographic sensor. So what happens when you're recording a video is that instead of the aperture opening and closing fast like it would when you are taking photos, it will open, stay open, and only closes when you stop filming. So while that is happening, the sensor and the retina, they're all healing up, and that can essentially damage the camera, affect the way you take photos or videos, and if you take the video for too long, you're gonna end up with static all over the screen. So I mainly use it for photography because that is the whole main reason I got this baby anyway. Nowadays, there are DSLR that are more friendly to videography. Unfortunately, mine is not. Nevertheless, it does record awesome quality footages. But since I mainly use it for photography and I need it for photography, I don't use it that often for my tutorials. For my lighting, I mostly use natural lighting, but I do enforce it with some artificial lights. Right now it's nighttime, so I have 7 lights shown at me right now. They're a combination of yellow and white and are hit on different directions of the screen. The yellow ones are particularly shot at me, 2 on the sides and 2 at the front. I use yellow lighting on me because I have a warm undertone skin, so the yellow will just make me appear more healthier. And the white is shown on the perimeter of my face and the backdrop so that you see the white, it's not too yellow, it's not too blue, it's neutral. No one asked about this, but I'm just gonna talk a little bit about my backdrop. If I get rid of this, you'll see my regular Keep Calm and Kill the Zombies poster right over there. And this is actually a canvas with an unfinished painting. I covered it with a nice looking wrapping paper, put it on the top of my easel, put the easel behind me, and that's my backdrop. So yeah, it's just a little fun tip if you guys want to change up your background without any commitment. For the little intro that I always have at the beginning of each video, I made that using Keynote. If you don't know what Keynote is, it is essentially the PowerPoint of Mac. And I'm gonna show you guys how I made it right now.
So this is the working layout for Keynote, and it's similar to PowerPoint if you're not familiar with it. So just make your title intro as if you're making a Keynote presentation. And for the photo, this is gonna be your best friend. A PNG file, which means there's no white backdrop. This is actually a watercolor painting that I made, and I just deleted the backdrop using Photoshop. Afterwards, you want to insert the image, whatever you want to, design whatever you want, and then just add in the cool effects of built-in effects. Share it, export to QuickTime, and manual advanced just makes the one slide appear longer, so I always use fixed timing. And the slide duration, how long do you want this video to be, 4 seconds. And the build duration, which is the changes in effects, it has a minimum of 1 second. Next, and then export it to any folder that you want. And after you export it, it's gonna end up like this.
For my editing software, I use Final Cut Pro X. A lot of people keep asking me this, so I use Final Cut Pro X, and I'm gonna show you guys how I do it and give you guys a little bit of pointers on my laptop.
So this is the working layout for Final Cut Pro. It's similar to iMovie. You have the timeline here where you drag all the stuff into, and then on the top corner right there you have the events library, and that's just gonna sort out your your videos and your images and everything. And once you import it, you just click that button right there and select the file and import it. And inserting is just the same, but anyways, I want to talk about this part, this little animation things that I usually have. Those are generators, and Final Cut Pro comes with a lot of cool things like these effects, and I actually purchased and downloaded some extra ones myself. And you can insert photo there, music, transitions, they have cool transitions, and also text. The text animations are always fun, but I just like to add more, like download it some more. And this is the fun part, generators. Now this is the part where a lot of people ask questions about. So like for example, this one. It came like that, so all you need to do, because it is default, so it's kind of like a template. All you have to do is drag it in and then insert whatever you want in it. So for example, let's just take this TV one that I use in my 20s flapper tutorial. Insert that to wherever you want to. I'm just gonna insert it randomly here. And then click it. And when you click it in the inspector, there's gonna be drop zones. You just insert the drop zone with any footage or images that you want. So just click the drop zone, select the footage. If you want to select a footage, you gotta drag out the cursor so that it selects a range. If you want a photo, just click once. And then afterwards, apply changes and you're done. So you can apply as many effects, images, text, music, objects, whatever you want on top of each other, as many as you want. For example, here generators also provide shapes which you can just drag, and then it comes with a lot of different shapes. Like for example, here I added two images on top of footage. You can transform it, just click transform, then that will let you resize it, move it around, and then also you can crop it and you can trim it, which means you can cut the size of the image to any rectangular ratio like this, or you can just make it a crop, which is essentially, you know, just cropping the image without any special ratio or anything like that. And then you can also can burns it, and if you use iMovie before, then you should know what can burns is. It's basically how the image will look like it's sweeping or transitioning, but I'm not gonna do any of that. And then you can also distort it, so you can just drag out the corners and distort the image. Like in my channel intro, you can see some of the image or footages on my laptop, and I distort an image on top of a video of my laptop to get that. And then another cool thing, so you click the footage you want, click transform, press space to play it, press stop, and click that little diamond shape on the top, play it again, stop it where you want to end, click the diamond thing again, and then do whatever you want with it, the change you want. So I'm just going to resize it. Done. And now when you play it, the footage will move. So that's what I've been doing in this video. And now color correction. Click the footage that you want. You can match the color of another footage in the project or in the event library to it, but I'm not gonna do that. Click correction, expand it, and here are some options. You can add a tint to the saturation, like for example, you can add a tint to everything, or you can just tint the shadow, you can just tint the mid tones, you can just tint the highlights. And this is what I usually do when the footage is a little bit too warm or too cold. I usually just select a shadow, a mid-tone, or a highlight. And if it's too warm, I'll drag it to the blue. If it's too cold, I'll drag it to the yellow. You can also set the saturation, amp it up all of it, amp up the shadow, amp up the mid-tone, amp up the highlight. And then the last part right there is exposure, which is the amount of light. So you can add it to the overall footage, or just to the shadows, just to the mid-tones, just to the highlight. So you can basically achieve any type of realistic image that you want. And on the corner here, you can save it as a preset. So what that does is that the next time you want to edit, you just open presets and select the one you want. Or you can copy it, select the footage you want to paste it to, and you can paste effects, which paste everything from color correction to music. Or paste attributes and pick which attributes of the original image that you want to copy.
So that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this and found some tips helpful. If you have tips and tricks of your own, please do share it down in the comment section below so we can all learn together. If you have any questions, comments, suggestions, video requests, also please comment down below, or if you're too shy to ask me on the comment section, just inbox me. I would love to reply every single one of you guys. And if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. I'll see you guys on the next video, and take care.